Hey everyone, ready for the next talk at EHSM, which is by Maciej Miznik, and he's from the Vacuum Measurement Lab of Tele and Radio Research Institute in Warsaw, as well as the Gdansk University of Technology. And his talk is going to be about the techniques, certain techniques and principles of mass spectrometry, including some sample measurement results, and he'll get into that. And welcome, Maciej.
Thank you for introduction. The topic of my presentation is principles of mass spectrometry. Short outline. First, I want to say something about history of mass spectrometry, something about mass selectors, vacuum systems, and I'm going to describe three analytical methods. It's a SIMS, GDMS, SSMS. I will show example results and we end conclude. The first device to separate isotopes was a Thomson parabolic mass spectrograph. It was constructed from glow discharge tube, and ions were formed in the glow discharge and accelerate between these electrodes and flow for this thin tube and separate in parallel magnetic and electric field and detect on the photographic plate. Some mass charge particles interact with magnetic and electric field, and this interact is described by a Lorentz formula. It is a vector sum of vector products of velocity of our charge and magnetic induction vector sum quotient charge of particles and intensity of electric field. So we calculate deviation our charge in x and y axis. And on the screen, it will show the parabolas. And this is an example of Thomson's mass spectra. And we know that the magnetic field charged particles interact with magnetic field, and magnetic sectors could be focused ion beams if the beam is collimated and monoenergetic. This property was advantageous by the Aston in 1990. This mass spectrograph used glow discharge ion source. Ion are accelerated between slits and this small ball. Next, beam is collimated, and by the electrostatic selector, we choose the only these ions which have one energy, and ions next are separated in magnetic sector and focus on the photographic plate. This is an example mass spectra in Aston experiment. And the next very important step in mass spectrometry is a Dempster mass spectrometer. Mass spectrographs are a device which detect ions on the photographic plate, but the spectrometer is the device which detect ions on the on the Faraday cup. It's a Faraday cup, and mass spectra is constructed point by point during the scan. We can scan by the changing of the intensity of magnetic field or change accelerating voltage, so we can change the mass, magnetic induction, or energy of ions. This spectrometer is used across electron impact source. Electrons are emitted from the hot cathode accelerator for this electrode, and during the heating, electron during the heating atoms are ionizing the gases, and the ions are formated and accelerated. Ions are accelerated between this electrode and this, and are biased in magnetic field, and arrive to the electric collector. It is another type of Dempster mass spectrometer. It is a heart of helium leak detector. This spectrometer has a cross electron impact source. It is a very simply symmetric electrostatic lens to focus ion beam. I said that the magnetic field could focus beam. Radial electric field could focus beam too, and this property was advantages by the Herzog and Matthews in 1933. In this spectrograph, this spectrograph is very nice because it has very high resolution. And if we put ion source in main slit in a focal length of electrostatic selector, outbeams will be parallel, and we have different beams with the same quotient mass to charge, and with different energies. This beam will be focused in one point on the photographic plate if we have a correct angles of electric and magnetic fields. The very popular in our time is a quadrupole mass spectrometer. It was constructed in 1953. It is constructed from four rods, which are connected by pair this and this and this with this. And to this pair of rods, we put a high frequency voltage with constant, and ions are oscillated between these rods and come to the collector, and only ions with a correct quotient mass to charge can flow from this selector, and we scan by changing this voltage, but the quotient of amplitude and constant must be constant during the scan. This is my simply vacuum system with to study chemical composition of vapor and the gases under the atmospheric pressure. It is electronics of the quadrupole mass analyzer. It is a chamber of quadruple mass analysis, a turbo molecular vacuum pump. It is a backstage rotary pump, and it is an intermediate pump because mass spectrometers twerk needs a high vacuum because in the air, free mean path of charge is very short, but in the vacuum, for example, in pressure 10 to the power minus 5, free mean path of proton is about 1 meter, but in atmospheric is 1 millimeter. So we need a high vacuum. And it is a main part of my Simply system. It's a copper diaphragm. Under this diaphragm is the next diaphragm, and I inserting vapor from the atmospheric pressure, and between my sample and ionizer of mass spectrometer, I must flow this sample from atmospheric to high vacuum by this volume. In this volume, I have pressure about 1 torr, and in mass spectrometer, I need pressure less than 10 to the power minus 4. So I must pumping my system, inlet system, by this small pump. It's example spectra for air, only for air. But when I insert isopropanol, I can see a molecular peak and fragmentation peaks of the isopropanol. In one time, inserting air and isopropanol, so I see peaks from air. The fragmentation, I see fragmentation peaks because during the heating, because if the electron, fast electron, hit the very long organic molecule, then it could cut of our molecule, so I see smaller parts of very big molecule of alcohol. I try something with a perfume. The main part of perfume is ethyl alcohol. It is a very peak 27. It's a very characteristic for the alcohol. It is this part of spectrum, but it's not separated because my quadruple is good tune. It's a spectra for ethyl acetate. The very important analytical method in solid state researches in a bulk analysis is a spark source mass spectrometer. Our device uses Matthews-Herzog geometry. And our sample is two spark electrodes. I put into this 5,000 volts, and in high vacuum I have a spark because distance between electrodes is about 100 microns, and I extract my ions between spark electrodes and accelerating electrodes. I have some to collimate the beam, and electric and magnetic sector, and photographic plate. It's a general view of our instrument. It is magnetic sector, electric sector, and chamber of ion source. This is a photography of spark electrodes, Venelt cap, and main slit. In mass spectrometry, very important is geometry. So on each step we must control geometry, so all slits has a mechanical system to tune slits. The next method which we used is a secondary ion mass spectrometry. It's a very useful method to research of chemical composition of surface. We can make maps of surface, depth profile, so we bombard the surface by the primary ion, fast primary ion beams, and sputter the material. During the sputtering, material is ionized, and ions we can measure by a quadruple mass spectrometer. We can sputter one monolayer and measure what we have on the surface, and sputter next monolayer, and next, and next, and next. So we have method to a very precision depth profiling. It's a schematic diagram of our instrument. It's an ion gun with cross electron impact source. To sputtering, we use argon beam. It is electron source. This is an ion optical column. It is a two electrostatic lens and two system to deflection our beam during the sputtering. And this is a electrostatic lens to extract ion, secondary ions, and this lens focused secondary ions in the inlet of a quadruple mass analyzer. This is a general view of our instrument. It is a leak valve to dose gases to ion source. This is a deflection system. It is a gate valve to ion glow pump. And it is an inlet sample inlet system, because this seems to work needs a very high vacuum. It is a 10 to the power minus 9 torr. It's a very, very low pressure. So we must put our sample from atmospheric pressure to high vacuum with two steps. So we have a very complicated vacuum system to transport our sample from atmospheric pressure to vacuum. This is a deflection system of ion guns, our sample. I think it is an organic light emitting diode on the ITO substrate. It is a first part of a symmetric ion lens of quadruple mass analyzer. This example mass spectrum from organic molecules from organic light emitting diodes. It's a peak from substrate. It is indium oxide, and we have a lot of fragmentation peak from our material. The next and methods which I want to describe is a glow discharge mass spectrometry. It's a very it's a similar method to SIMS. By to ionizing, we used a glow discharge. First, we glow discharge sputtered material from cathode. It's our sample, and the next step, sputtered material is ionizing and extract by this diaphragm. This is a method faster than Sims because sputtering rate in Sims is about 0.1 nanometer per second, but in this experiment it is 20 or 40 nanometers per second. It's a general view of discharge cell. It's a sample, it's a seal isolator, anode from stainless steel and skimmer or diaphragm, which extract ions to a mass spectrometry. In a glow discharge cell, we have pressure about 1 or 0.5 torr. It is a view of our instrument. It is an electrostatic ion lens. This is a quadrupole mass analyzer. Inside our lens, we have an energy filter with a Bessel box because quadrupole analyzer separate only slow ions. Ions which have energy more than 40 electronvolts will not separate it. So we must cut off this part, we must cut off these ions, and slow ions are biased in electrostatic field and focused in this point. It is some depth profile analysis. We measured chromium and titanium layer on the steel. We have a depth profile. It's the same in the two different methods. And I thank you for your attention.
We have time for some questions, if people would have any questions they'd like to ask. Anyone? Well, thank you for your time. Thanks for the nice talk.
Thank you.